Lewis acids and bases. The year is 1923. Scientists Broasted-Lowry published a theory about acids and bases and defined them by how they react in purified water. They stated that acids donate a proton and bases take them away. However, there are limitations to this theory. The condition was that it had to have a solvent and hydrogen ions, which is all fine and dandy if you're holed up in your laboratory and you're recreating reactions with protic solvents. But how do you explain reactions that happen outside of these parameters? But Gilbert Lewis, probably while smoking an imported cigar, said to the world, this is a very one-sided definition. He invited us to see these reactions happening in a different way, through electrons. He said that acids are electron acceptors and bases are electron donors. Turns out, this theory opens a lot of doors for chemists. For example, we can call aluminum fluoride an acid and sulfide a base, thanks to his new and improved viewpoint. So let's talk about atoms and molecules that can be Lewis acids. All cations can be Lewis acids. It's because they have the electron availability. This includes copper 2, iron 2, iron 3, hydrogen, etc. Any atom, ion, or molecule with an incomplete octet of electrons, molecules where the central atom can have more than 8 valence shell electrons, or in other words, expandable octets, and polar double bonds. On the other side of the coin, we have the Lewis bases. So which molecules can be bases? Any anion can be a Lewis base because they have extra electrons to spare. A Lewis base can be any atom with unshared pairs in their valence electron shell, any molecule that has a double bond, and the other end of the polar bond. 1. Lewis acids and bases are defined by electron. 2. Acids accept electrons and bases donate them. 3. Anything positively charged, something without a complete octet, or anything with an expandable valence electron shell can be a Lewis acid. And lastly, 4, anything negatively charged, any unshared pairs in the valence shells, and anything with a double bond can be a Lewis base.